Good morning, dear students. Today I am going to discuss about the new concept, that's adiplasty. For the previous session that I have been discussion about the what actually mean by the adiplasty and also its definition that we have been discussion. Now its derivation that we are going to derive. See what actually mean by the adiplasty. How can you able to say? Say, let us say this is the conductor. So far, the conductor of length that is the L. See, this is a battery. We are supposed to apply some of that field, actually field to this conductor. As already we studied in the previous class. The conductor, there must be number of free electrons are there. These free electrons, they are moving randomly with some velocities, some speed, they are moving randomly. When we apply some more that external field, then what happens? These electrons gets drifted in a particular order. So far, it is because of some influence of that electric field. So that these electrons gets drifted in a particular direction. They must be streamlined. How we can able to say? So that's what the drift velocity. It's an average velocity with which, simple one, say the definition of this drift velocity. Say average velocity. Average velocity, the free electrons. Average velocity of free electrons, average velocity of the free electrons get drifted, how get drifted in a metallic conductor under the influence, get drifted in a metallic conductor under the influence of electric field. What we suppose now? Influence of that electric field. Of an electric field. This is a simple concept now. Say, this is a conductor. In this conductor, there are some more that free electrons, they get drifted. How we can able to say that electrons, they must be drifted in this way. They are moving with some velocities. This is an electric field we can say. Say positive and negative, this is a battery. So for the positive charge Q and negative charge, that's a Q. So far, in this particular consideration, this is a conductor of length is that L. That should be connected between that battery, means there must be some that external field must be applied to this conductor. So in this case that I would like to analysis, let us consider a conductor of length that L. So that should be connected with that battery as shown in this figure. In this case, what we supposed to know, say that L be the length of the conductor. L be the length of the conductor and E be that electric field, you can say. Say that electric field, V be the potential difference across the two ends of the conductor. V be the potential difference across the two ends of the conductor. Battery must be connected to this conductor now. E be the charge of the electron. Can able to use the Q also. And Vd be the drift velocity of the electrons, of free electrons. Let me take that Vd is drift velocity. Velocity of free electrons. See about this particular concept that we can able to visualize. even also the same concept, there must be the movement of these electrons. While random motion, what happens now? There must be conjugative, successive collision. There must be some more, the gap is there. The gap, that's what relaxation time. Of course, you can able to write tau is the relaxation time. Relaxation time. That already you know that. What actually mean by that? Relaxation time. So for this explanation that you can able to explain, then after that, say magnitude of that electric field. Yes. Then magnitude of electric field E equal to V by L. We call that is equation number. E is that electric field, V be the potential difference between two ends of the conductor, L be the length of that conductor. Under the influence of this electric field, whatever that electrons, free electrons gets drifted with their velocity, that's a drift velocity. If that electric field must be influenced, electric field must be applied, that electron experiences some more the force. That force, let me know that in this case, if that electric field, say, applied, influence, that electric field must be applied now. Electric field must be applied, then what happens? It influences that some force now. Electric field influences some force on that electron. Electric field influences force on an electron, that is what E into E equal to that F with negative sign. So for E into E, or sometimes you may be able to say QE, say that's what F. There must be some force will be experienced on that, say that electron. Then what we supposed to know? We have the basic relation. Say F equal to MA, that relation, A equal to what now? F divided by that M. See, that F is the force must be experienced on it using this particular relation now. Because of this, there is some force must be experienced on it. But we have got that F, say then A equal to minus E into E divided by M. Say that A is nothing but that's what now, there must be some acceleration of those free electrons. That A be the acceleration of the free electron. Let me know here, A be the acceleration of free electron. We have got that A equal to E divided by, say that is that M. But in this case, there must be some relaxation time. I would like to analyze this in this case. That tau be the relaxation time, is the relaxation time. Already we know that what actually mean by this relaxation time for drift velocity of the electrons. Time and Vd be the drift velocity. Then what we supposed to analyze in these particular considerations? Yes, this Vd equal to, say that's a velocity. This velocity equal to what now here? The acceleration into tau. Vd is the drift velocity. A into tau. So far we know that A equal to EE divided by M. Then I can write this Vd equal to EE tau divided by M. This is the basic relation. So that negative sign, what it indicates, that negative sign, ultimately it is always opposite to that of the direction of electric field. Whatever the velocity of these free electrons must be opposite to that of the direction of electric field. See, that electrons must be drifting in this way. That's what now with that velocity Vd, that electric field will be in this direction. So whatever the free electrons, they must be drifted opposite to the direction of the electric field. So that is the negative sign that we have been taken. So far, the drift velocity, that expression, the drift velocity equal to E tau divided by M. This is the basic relation now. The negative sign, it should be what now? Opposite to the direction of electric field. Direction of, say, electric field. That is what is supposed to be. This is the one of the important concept for the examination point of view, especially for annual examination in the year March 2016 and June 2016. It was asked in the annual examination for the board examination. You try to understand. It's a very simple concept. Enappa na helthiyo drift velocity andre enu antu gott maadkobeku. What actually mean by the drift velocity? See, so average velocity of the free electrons get drifted. Say that's what? In a metallic conductor, opposed under the influence of that electric field. They must be drifted in this way. You can able to explain what actually it's a conductor of length. Either conductor length has to be L ide. And this conductor should be connected with that battery power supply. So what the potential difference between two ends of this conductor, that should be that P anthirabodu. Electric field must be applied here. And E be the charge of the electron, tau be the relaxation time, that all the things that we have been taken. And after that, you must know that namagottu enappa electric field relation equal to V by L anta agutte. So for electric field, implant some force on that particular electron. So avagenu E equal to F anta helta hogtivu. Namagottu relation E equal to F divided by Q. Hence, that F equal to QE. Now, previous topic, they will consider it exactly the same way that we have been taking. Because the negative sign, it is opposite to the direction of the electric field. That's what we are supposed to know. Then F equal to MA. There must be some force. That's a basic relation. Using that electron, AB, that acceleration of that electron. Because we must apply that electric field, there must be some influence of that electric field. Obviously, electron gets accelerated. That's an electron. Say that A be the acceleration of that free electron, F divided by M. Just you substitute and simplify, we have got this particular relation. Vd equal to minus E tau by M. E negative sign yakappa andra opposite to that of the direction of, say, the electric field. Free electrons E direction nalli iruttada, electric field E direction nalli iruttada. Adakke naavu helthivu Vd equal to E tau by M. This is the most important expression, that is what we have been studied now. Now, relation between electric current and drift velocity. The relation between drift velocity as well as the electric current, it's also that very important concept now. Let us consider that conductor, as already we know that, say conductor of length is that L. This conductor must be connected with that battery. This is the battery, positive and negative. See, let us consider that conductor of length is that L and its cross-sectional area is that A. L is the length of the conductor, cross-sectional area that A. V be the potential difference between two ends of the conductor, and Vd be the drift velocity, E be that electric field, say drift velocity, Vd be the drift velocity of that electrons, they are drifted in that particular conductor now. So that we can able to explanation here. Say for here, consider conductor, you must know that, consider a conductor of length L. L be the length of this conductor, Vd be the drift velocity, Vd be the drift velocity of these free electrons, E be that electric field, V be the electric field, E be the electric field, V be the potential difference between two ends of the conductor. And also in these particular considerations, whatever that electric field must be set up for in this conductor, then what happens? Of course, the E be the electrons. They are moving like this. So far, here, E be that electrons, and M be the mass of that electron, So, these are the things that better we try to explain. But we know that if that electric field be applied on this conductor, these electrons gets drifted opposite to that of the direction of that electric field. We have that relation, say that E equal to V by L. It's the most important expression. E equal to V by L, where V be the potential difference between two ends of the conductor, E be that electric field, L be the length of that conductor now. So after that, say let N be the number of free electrons. Free electrons present in this particular conductor of the entire that volume of this conductor. N be the number of electrons present entire this volume of the conductor now. What about the total number of electrons present in this conductor? How can you able to say? Yes. Number of free electrons in a entire volume of the conductor. Volume of conductor. So, after that, what we are going to find out now? Total number of electrons present in this conductor should be equal to. Therefore, total number of electrons. Total number of electrons present in that conductor. In a conductor, should be equal to N number of free electrons. Then into volume of the conductor. Say, it's what now? Volume of the conductor. N into A into that N. A is the cross-sectional area of the conductor. L be the length of the conductor. So, after this, if suppose E be the charge of the electron. E be the charge of the electron in which how many number of electrons? Say N into AL. These are all total number of electrons in this conductor. After that, then what we are going to find? What is the total charge in that conductor that we can able to analyze now? Let me know that total charge in that conductor. Then E is the charge of the electron. Then total charge. That's Q. Q equal to, that's what? E into N into AL. Say, this is the total charge of these electrons present in that conductor. We have got the total charge Q equal to E into, say, N AL. So, after that, we must able to know that whatever these electrons gets movement, there must be some more the time taken by these charge. Let me know that. If the charge, that already you get it now that too. Say, what is the time taken to that charge must be moving in that particular conductor? Let me know that how exactly it is. What is the, say, time taken, this charge across this particular conductor? That also we can able to say. Then, time taken to the charge cross the conductor. So that T equal to what now? Yes, that T equal to, say that L divided by VD. We can say this one is NAL. NAL into that E. Call that is equation number 2. And T equal to L divided by VD, that is equation number 3. Where VD is what now? Drift velocity. of those free electrons in that conductor. So after this, what is the current? As already we know that. What is meant by the current? Charges must be flowing. The time rate of flow of electric charges constitute that electric current. Then what I suppose to know? Say the time rate of flow of charges. As usual in this case, say I equal to Q by T. I equal to Q by T. Say now Q equal to N A L into E divided by T is L by V. L will get cancelled. It is say VD E N A. So far, the expression for the electric current, now we must be able to know that here. Say that I equal to VD E N A. This is the expression for the electric current. The relation between that electric current as well as particularly what we supposed to know. I equal to VD E into N into A. Let me know that. I equal to V N A. Let me know. We can easily remember this one. I equal to V E N A. So, the relation connecting between drift velocity as well as that electric current and the drift velocity. With reference to this, how that I is related with that VD. If suppose here E, N and A R remains constant, then I is proportional to that VD. Can be able to analysis of. That is what I said. Remaining all these factors constant, then I is proportional to that VD. Remaining all are the constant. This is the most important that expression. Especially for the board examination point of view, always they may be able to ask me. Sometimes we can able to use that VD equal to I divided by, say VD equal to I divided by NEA or simply I equal to NQA. Anyhow, we can able to use that. But the same thing. I by A is current density, VD equal to the relation. I by A is J, J by NQ or J divided by NE. How the relation connecting between VD as well as current density, all the things we can able to use. So for ultimately, whatever that relations that we can able to use to solving some more example, that's most important one. So here, again, in this case, that's what we supposed to know about the drift velocity concept. So what is the assignment? The velocity is the same as that of meter per second. The dimensional formula is also the same thing. The SI unit of the drift velocity is also the meter per second. The dimensional formula the same as that of the velocity. So after this one, then one more concept is there here. Say that's the mobility now. See, what is the mobility? So sometimes they may be able to ask the one more questions. Say, what is mean by that mobility now? Say, in this case, that's what now? Mobility of the current. Say, mobility of the current. That we can able to represent in that letter mu. Say that mobility of the current, how we can able to say? Mobility of current carrier, how we can able to visualize this mobility of this, say, current carrier. Mobility mu equal to, that's ratio of VD divided by, that's E. Mu equal to VD divided by the E, that's mobility. As usual, we can able to analyze here. Sometimes they may able to ask that one more questions. The mobility of that electric current carrier, it is the ratio of drift velocity to that of the, say, drift velocity of the current carrier to the, say, that's electric, applied electric field, that is what we call it now, say, mobility of that particular current carrier. So far in this case, that VD here, that VD equal to what now? What is that particular relation? VD equal to E tau divided by M. Then I can write mu equal to E tau divided by M 4 divided by the t, it cancels. I can write e tau divided by m. Mobility also we can able to write in terms of e tau divided by, that is the one, say that is the relation. Say mobility, how can able to write that their SI units now? Simple way, it's a meter per second and it is Newton per Coulomb now. Say ultimately what we can able to say, that meter per second per Newton Coulomb. Say this is the SI unit of this mobility, that we can able to write like this. You want also the same way dimensional formula, we can also write this one. Sometimes about this particular relations. Say this is also that one more that write that unit. We can also write say the same thing here, meter per second and volt per meter it is. Volt per meter, how can able to write? Meter square per second per voltage. So this is also the SI unit of this mobility. We can write like this also. So for all these considerations, always we can able to express that mobility as well as drift velocity and that electric that's current now. With reference to this, we must have the basic relations, especially for solving the numericals. All these formulae are very important, how they are interrelated to each physical quantities. For example, you know that, say that Vd, using this, say that mobility mu equal to Vd by E, it's a relation. Vd equal to what? E into mu or mu E, this is also that one relation. But we know that electric current I equal to V now. Say now it is I equal to Vd E, say Na, this is the electric current, that relation. But I can able to write that I equal to, say particularly that I equal to Vd E Na, that is the relation. With reference to this, just we can able to substitute that values here. Say that I equal to E Na particularly, and also that Vd value, say E N A, Vd value is E into mu. So far we can write that I value E N A mu, say that is the E mu. This is also we can able to write that relations, but we know that particular that values, how we can able to understand the entire this expression. Sometimes always we can able to use to solving some numericals. All these relations we must use to solve some numericals in this current electricity now. So for basic concept regarding that mobility and drift velocity, the relation connecting between electric current as well as drift velocity. So for the next session, that I would like to discussion about the, say some more that derivation of that Ohm's law, say, and also their limitations, that I will discuss in the next session.